Hey guys, this is Texas 252, and what I've got for you guys today is a review of Crusader Destiny by Divide Arts. Just gonna let it load up. I apologize because we have to narrate this after I filmed it, as my microphone is completely broken. So, I might be talking something slightly different than having it on screen, just because of the lineup. So actually load into the game again. Okay, so you've got the little red joystick, which you can move around, which is alright, controls are fairly decent. You've got a map in the top corner, and you buy different parts of different maps as you progress through the game. You can run around in the bottom right hand corner, you can see skills. You can choose three major ones, and then you can hit the little arrows next to it and you can choose your next three, etc. And there's a decent amount of skills to unlock, and I'll show you that in a minute. So that was a magic attack. The attacks all have different animations, and some have different conditions, like some you have to be standing behind them, some you have to be, the guy you're shooting has to be standing still, etc, etc. And different monsters have different resistances, so it makes the game more interesting. This is your inventory. Everything you've got equipped. We've got a nice little 3D representation of the cell. Quests, little description, skills, so there we can move the skills around. So there, each of your little three sets you can have. There are the skills you can get as you progress through the game. And then stats, and you can put your skill points into different stats. You've got melee, bow, and magic, and armors, like your weapons can up each one. Some options. So as 3D games go on Android, it's some one of the best graphically, but also as the sort of RPG genre goes, it's one of the better ones. It's probably on a par with Xenonia, because the gameplay on Xenonia is really good. This just has the graphics as well. It's a little bit grindy. It does take quite a while to level up, and everything's really expensive. So it does take a while to buy items, so there's a lot of grinding involved, but it is quite a nice game, and the graphics make that a little bit more bearable. There's a load more maps as you progress through the game. There's dungeons, bosses, many more monsters. It's just a really quick little run through. I think it's about 60 hours of gameplay at least, so it should be pretty good. There's a title you just pick up and play for a while. Here's a little dungeon, as you can see that shot, you have to be standing still to hit them, but they were moving so they didn't hit. And yeah guys, that's really all I can say. I've recorded a little bit more so I'm just going to let this run on. I'll just run you back to the village and show you buying items and selling items and upgrading skill points, but I'll be going now. I might put some music into the back end of this, and I apologise for the microphone. I'll try and get it fixed, because I know this quality is crap, and I actually want to be able to narrate them as I do them, make something a bit more real, and actually know what I'm talking about, so I can actually see it. So yeah, this has been Texas Chickies for you guys, and I'll see you guys later.